Hello, good evening students. In last class we have discussed few protective systems. Now today's class we have to see the air brake, circuit breaker and protective relaying system. It is well known fact the power system is constructed with many equipments and machines and its accessories. For example, the design of electrical system from generating station to distribution of electricity through the T&D lines, all different type of equipments like bus bar, generator, transformer and step up transformer, step down transformer and respective accessories are involved. Hence, a suitable protective system is needed for the power system, because if a fault occurs minimum 10 to 15 times more than rated current will flow, and it will definitely damage the electrical equipments are installed in the power system. Hence, more danger situation will occur. Hence, in such condition we have to protect power system from different fault situations and atmospheric lightning strokes. Hence, in this manner we have to provide a sophisticated protection system. So within few seconds the fault should clear. Otherwise, if a fault stays in the circuit for more time, then it will damage the entire performance of equipments installed in the power station. What are the different equipments? It may be generator, it may be transformer, it may be bus bars, it may be towers, again it may be feeders. Hence, you go on, all the systems, all the equipments are very important and costly. So we don't know in 24 hours when the fault may occur. The fault occurs due to different situations. It may be due to wrong connections, it may be due to failure of insulation, it may be due to not proper operation of the system. Any situation may occur, different type of faults. Hence, we have to protect each component involved in power system. Hence, in that one, circuit breaker is also one important protective system, because it is one of the electrical switch. It breaks the circuit or it makes the circuit by remote control. So it may be operated by manually in normal condition, but the breaking of making of circuit maybe takes place to the automatically during fault conditions. It is a switching device. A circuit breaker is a switching mechanism which is used to protect the power system or power system equipments. It is widely operated with in the reliability condition with protective relays. Always relays will detect the type of fault and sends the message for operation of circuit breaker. For different protection systems, different type of devices are required. So when the normal working condition is there, the contacts of circuit breakers are closed. That is called it makes the circuit. When the fault conditions are there, both contacts are going to separate. That means it creates a open circuit. While opening the two points or two contacts of a circuit breaker, huge amount of arc is developed due to ionization of air. Due to ionization of air, a arc is formed. Arc is a conducting path. Arc formed between two contacts, it shows there is a conducting path. This arc should be suppressed. This arc should be quenched. Hence, depending upon arc quenching medium, the type of circuit breaker are classified. If air is used as a arc quenching medium, then it is referred as air circuit breaker. If oil is used as a arc quenching medium, then it is referred as oil circuit breaker. If gas is used, then gas circuit breaker, because SF6 gas is more popular due to high advantages. You can observe it is an external construction of air circuit breaker with different parts, because so many advancement of electronic systems, semiconductor materials, now we are using electronic based solid state relays. It shows one of the operation. This diagram shows internal parts of previous solid state electronics based relay. So how the circuit breaker operates? It is already well known. It mainly consists two contacts. One is called fixed contact, one is called moving contact. So these two contacts are contacted, that circuit is on during the normal working condition. When the fault occurs, these relays are going to open, these points are going to open. That means moving contact should be separated from fixed contact. At this time, more amount of arc is developed due to ionization of air or conducting path. This formation of arc should be controlled by arc quenching medium. Hence, in air brake type of circuit breaker, air is used as a arc quenching medium. This diagram, you can observe there are two contacts. One is a fixed contact, another one is moving contact. In different systems, moving contact may be arranged by some spring action. So during the normal working condition, these two contacts are connected. Hence, where the circuit breaker is used, that electric circuit works normal condition. But when the fault occurs, relay will sense the fault, then it sends the message to the circuit breaker to open the contact. At that time, this moving contact is going to separate. At this instant, a high amount of arc is produced, because it creates the conducting path, because already your electric circuit is working, which you have to protect. The large amount of arc should be quenched or controlled or suppressed. It is achieved by a high pressure of air should force between two contacts. Hence, arc is lengthened. Arc should be taken away from these two contacts with the help of arc splitters. Arc splitters are different compartments or different cabins, which is constructed by heat insulating material, just like porcelain cabins. In each cabin, arc is separated. Hence, it is suppressed. It is the main operating principle of air brake circuit breaker. Again, this is also same principle. Air blast circuit breaker. Different types of air circuit breakers are available depending upon axial flow and depending upon blast. Air blast. In this arrangement, you can clearly observe fixed contact and moving contacts are placed in vertically in vertical position, but the direction of high pressurized air forces due to compression chamber. High pressurized air is generated in air chamber, air compressor. When the contacts are going to open, at that moment high pressurized air should be blasted, should be forced between these two contacts. Again, this force of air takes the arc away from the chamber. Arc is suppressed due to the different type of cabins. Again, arc splitters, it is also called arc chutes. Hence, in this manner, the arc formation is suppressed through the air blast. That means forced air. So, this method is called air blast type of circuit breaker. Such a system can be used up to 15 kV and rupturing capacity about 2500 MVA. So, you understand any one type very clearly, you practice the diagram and few points you have to prepare. Then, what are the advantages of the such type of circuit breaker? Number one, the risk of fire is eliminated in operation, because if we are using oil circuit breaker, the arc formation is not free from fire. So, we are using air as a arc quenching medium, there is less formation of fire. Speed of circuit breaker is much higher during the operation. Arc quenching is much faster, that means lengthening of arc, suppression of arc is very fast. The duration of arc is same for all values of current, it is also one of important. Stability of operation can be maintained, and whole system requires less maintenance. Some disadvantages also we can observe. It depends upon air supplier, plant requires additional maintenance. That means, continuously all 24 hours the pressurized air must be available. If it is not working, then it leads to more danger. Always high pressurized air reservoir should be ready. It contains high capacity air compressor. This is also one of important. It requires maintenance. Proper pressure of air should be maintained. There is a chance of air pressure leakage. It is also a very important point, that only I am telling. Some maintenance is required for proper pressure. If leakage occurs, then proper pressure is not available, then it is gives very risk. The air has relatively lower arc extinguishing properties as compared to gas arcing properties. What is the SF6? Why the SF6 is popular? Because SF6 gas has so much arc quenching properties. So, such type of circuit breakers are used mainly in generation plants, for protection of generation plants. It is also used for common protection of electrical machines. Electrical machines means we are generating the electricity from AC generators, three-phase AC generators. Hence, one machine may cost in terms of crore rupees. One transformer may cost in terms of crore rupees. Hence, protection of all equipments installed in power system, it is necessary. Getting the idea? If any fault occurs, if damage occurs, then we have to replace the electrical machines, electrical generators, electrical transformers, then it requires again huge investment. Hence, customer may happy or unhappy. Otherwise, the generation cost may goes on increasing. It is unwanted from consumer side. Hence, air circuit breaker is also used in electricity sharing system. About 15 kilovolts. It is also used in low as well as high voltage and high current applications. So, depending upon the arc quenching medium, the circuit breakers are classified as if oil is used as a arc quenching medium, such circuit breakers are referred as oil circuit breaker. If air is used as an arc quenching medium, such circuit breakers are referred air circuit breaker. If gas is used, SF6 gas is used, the name is referred as SF6 circuit breaker. If vacuum is used as an arc quenching medium, the name abbreviated as vacuum type circuit breaker. You can use these two diagrams for explanation also. Air blast circuit breaker. You can use these two diagrams also, whichever you want. This is, if you feel easy, this one you can use, or earlier you can use. You can see here, in figure number 1, there is a fixed contact, there is a moving contact, arc shoots, arc splitter arrangement is there, arc contact is there. So, this is contact, moving contact and fixed contact are closed during the normal working condition. If there is no flow of abnormal current, abnormal situation, when the fault current flows through the electric circuit, then circuit breaker should open. Hence, it has to protect the electrical equipment of power system. Hence, at that time, relay will sense the fault. Relay, particular type of relay, will sense the fault and sends the signal to the circuit breaker to operate. When it receives the signal from relay, the circuit breaker is going to open. Hence, arc is formed. This arc is taken into arc splitters, arc chutes. Then, through the air, arc should be suppressed. Now, you can observe basic relay principle, simple basic working principle. You can see there, some battery is there, switch is there. So, this battery is used to energize the trip coil. It maintains the trip coil. So, one switch is there, one control switch is there. Here, this side lamp is there, lamp is referred as load. Supply point is there. In secondary side, when relay is contacted, when the current flows 230 volts, this load, when it is closed circuit. When it is closed circuit, the current will flow. Getting the idea? So, here I want to control the relay. When the lamp or load draws a fault current, this message goes to energize trip coil. Some magnetic properties are developed, then it will attract. It may be close the circuit or it may be open the circuit. Different type of relay options are there. Normally open circuit condition, normally closed condition circuit. Hence, normally closed condition means your circuit is on, current is flowing, functioning is there. When the fault occurs, it will open. Normally closed, then it will open. Normally open, your functioning will take place. When the fault occurs, your system should be closed, your switch is closed. Getting the idea? Two types are possible, normally open, normally closed. Here only one thing you understand, trip coil, when it is energized, when fault occurs, there is a magnetism, there is a some metal, then iron metal, it will attract. Trip coil is activated when the fault situation. At that time, it will attract iron part. Hence, it will operation. You understand very thoroughly. This is the basic principle. Relays are used along with the coordination of circuit breaker. Different type of relays are there. Over current, such type of relays are used to protect the system from over current. The relay activates when the abnormal current flows, fault current flows, then it will sends the message to circuit breaker, open. Getting the idea? Similarly, in over voltage relay, it will activated when the system voltage increases more than normal value. Then again, it will sends the message to circuit breaker to open the system. In this manner, you understand. Today I uploaded two videos in YouTube. You better go through that. You will get the idea. These are animation working principle. Thank you to one and all.